bisexual and go by she?
So I am a bisexual and I consider my gender as he/she.
I identify as a bisexual and I also identify as a female. They definitely think that we have a choice and we choose to be the way we are. It's definitely does not work that way. I know some people who who really find the nerve to come and tell me that, but it's a choice, right? I'm like, absolutely not. It's not. It's definitely not a choice.
It's basically getting judged by the people and the crowd that you're talking to. Because nowadays people are actually aware, but if you're not talking to the right crowd, I think you'll get judged and that might affect you mentally.
But when I'm talking about my gender identity, when I were to like tell anybody it's a he/she, they kind of like they take a step back and they just like, okay, like they ask me to explain it, and sometimes some people don't get it. Family, I haven't told them yet and I'm planning not to tell them. But with my friends, I feel like I've become a lot closer. It's actually been really fun. Even they they help me like set up with other people. So they used to not find like a big issue, but sometimes when it was just me hanging out with the guys, they would like, let's say we were at a restaurant or we were at like a public place, they would look at a girl and they would make a very objectified comment about them, and I used to be very uncomfortable. So I used to be like, guys, that's really not cool. So they would be like, dude, I thought you were attracted to girls. You're also supposed to make comments like this. Like, so they expected me to like also be part of their conversation just because, you know, I told them that's like, regardless of you being attracted to any gender, I don't think it's cool to objectify anybody from any gender.
This whole community has been going, it goes way back, but in India, the subject has been very loud recently.
I feel like it's high time India just accepted that people are different from each other and move on with their lives. And I feel like the cases regarding parents sending them to gay conversion camps and rehabilitation centers and disowning the kids, throwing them out of the house, all of that is genuinely very alarming to see. So I feel like India has a long way to go, but there's also been milestones like the Section 377.
It's nice how these generations, they're open to it and they support it, not just accept it, but support it to their fullest. And then all the pride marches and the government legalizing it, it's very supportive. And even the movies, the Tamil movie Super Deluxe, I think the movie really helped a lot of older generations to get what it is.
And there are more people fighting for it, there are more people, like more celebrities being vocal about it, whether it's India or outside. There are more and more people coming out, so I feel like there is a level of understanding. Like, there are leaders that are promising a better future for this LGBTQ community, and people are voting for these leaders accordingly, and that is actually a very significant milestone, like I told you. And these are things that we need to look into, like when you're appointing policymakers, when you're appointing politicians and people in power.
The story of the person is very inspiring. Dr. Trinitra, he was born as a guy, and then she took hormonal treatment for 3 years and she's still taking, and she changed her gender and she's very proud of it. And I just love how she embraces that side of her and how she stands up for the whole community.
I don't have like LGBT role models, but I do follow a few people, but not particularly for this, actually. Like for example, Alok, if you know about Alok, he is, he's a very woke person. Like, he talks about a lot of issues and he talks about the history of these issues and why it's like this and why it's not like this. So I feel like I follow them because they've genuinely like talk about these serious issues. And also when they express their sexual orientation, it's very vibrant and colorful. Their makeup is like always on point. I think now it's gotten better, but I remember like at one point the LGBTQs were the butt of the joke. There were a lot more people they didn't talk about.
Like, what I mean is, if there's a transgender portrayal, then the transgenders, it's the struggles of the transgender, which has already been, you know, it's already been spoken about a lot of times. So right now, just a normal transgender, you know, normal person's life, like they just want to be portrayed like how they are, they have a life. So, I mean, that's not been done.
But when shows come up, like for example, you know about the show called Sex Education, yeah? So in that, they talk about various types of orientations. Like there's pansexual, there's asexual, and there is a queer, like different types of queer women and men. So I feel like all of those, that is progress. Like you can see that media is trying to be progressive. One of the reasons, one of the ways is this, like you can do documentaries, interviews with people who are part of the community.
And then social media, definitely, it's one of the easiest and quickest way to reach everyone.
So, and also because our current generation, Generation XYZ, they're all very visual learners. So I feel like movies and TV shows, like I told you, like Sex Education, movies, shows like that actually make an impact. So I feel like when you are exposed to medias and you are exposed to things like this on the news channels and everything, that's when you realize you can spread a certain amount of awareness about it.
I feel like in educational institutions at base level can conduct a seminar or can conduct, you know, something of that sort just to make sure that others are also included. And it's just basically the educational institutions, when they don't talk about it, they just basically promote straight, you know, orientation throughout, and which is not right.
Before it, the gay culture came during the peak season of the bikers and leather phase, where they were just getting to the thing, and when they found out, they actually stood for it. They stood up for what they believed, and then all the pride parades, which is just celebrating a day of all of us together and things that we believe.
And it's so beautiful to watch because it's just genuinely a bunch of people enjoying themselves, expressing themselves at the most beautiful part of their lives, you know. And they're like these music videos that come out that even represent the pride parade, and people coming out and them telling their parents, the YouTube videos on that, all of those are actually very inspirational and genuinely encourages more and more people to come out to their parents and like live their life completely with incorporating their sexual orientation as part of it.